YouTube, what's going on? If you're new here, my name's Roger. I own a company called QVO Tactical where we make holsters and gear and also film content for this channel. In today's video, we are taking a look at a new offering from one of my favorite rifle manufacturers, American Defense Manufacturing, and their UIC Mod 2 SPR.
Hey. Safe.
Now, if you're familiar with the channel, then you know I've been rocking ADM's UIC lineup for the last few years. You also know that I've kind of had the long range bug as of lately. I've been doing a lot of AR precision matches and shooting a lot more for distance, if you will. Now, before we get this review underway, I always like to tell you guys how I go about getting products in for review. I've had a working relationship with ADM for the last few years. Everything from reviewing and marking their products all the way to helping with police department approval here in Las Vegas. As I started getting more into AR precision shooting, I reached out to my buddies over at ADM and I checked out what they had to offer in the 18-inch range. I immediately came across their UIC Mod 2 SPR or Special Purpose Rifle, and I knew right away that's exactly what I was looking for. I reached out to my ADM buddies and pitched the video idea and asked if they wanted to collab for the video. They liked the idea and they sent the rifle out to me for us to keep and to use for this video and for some future videos. I appreciate their support as always, and this rifle will also help us out with future reviews because I have a few scopes that I've been wanting to do reviews and create content for, so thank you for that. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get into the specs. Now, when it comes to the ADM SPR, one might simply state that it's just a longer version of the UIC Mod 2, and they wouldn't be wrong. And that's also great because the UIC Mod 2 is an awesome rifle. However, if you're new to American Defense Manufacturing, there is so much that goes into the UIC Mod 2 that makes it arguably one of the best one-and-done rifles on the market. Let me explain. The American Defense Manufacturing Universal Improved Carbine features a fully ambidextrous lower receiver which has bolt catches, bolt releases, safety selectors, and magazine releases on both sides of the rifle. It is a completely ambidextrous gun. With this being a billet lower receiver, they also made sure to include an enlarged trigger guard. Now, one feature some people might not even know about is the internal tensioning screw. This can be adjusted from inside the lower receiver, which will take out any wiggle or play between the upper and lower receiver. Next thing is the two-stage match trigger, which is typically a Geissele trigger, my favorite, as you guys already know. They also include their own HD buffer and a Magpul PRS stock. Now, I opted out for the PRS stock and went with a Magpul SL stock. I did this because I typically like to set up these rifles like how I would want to use them if I were in the field. For example, the DMR SPR, the program here for the guys in the police department here in Vegas, they run rifle setups like this. My concern was that if you end up going from an overwatch position and then you have to move inside a building where now you're having to clear rooms, do room clearing, stuff like that, it's not going to be the easiest thing to do with that PRS stock. So with that 18-inch rifle, I know it's not ideal for room clearing. However, switching out to an SL stock, it's something that I can still manage, and it'll be much easier to do than using that PRS stock. But that's just for me, guys. If this is a rifle that you're going to use primarily for competition or maybe hunting, then you might want to just stick with that Magpul PRS stock because it is a really good stock for precision. Okay, so moving on to the upper receiver, let's start with the most important component, the barrel. This particular build comes with an 18-inch 1/8 twist Criterion stainless steel barrel that is nitride finished and chambered in 223 Wild. So real quick, I want to share something with you guys. You know those videos or like your friends that you go out and shoot with that are really awesome shots and they do like some crazy like tight group where all the rounds are touching? Yeah, this barrel does that. It does it for you. It's crazy. Don't get me wrong, you got to do your work behind the gun, but it is great to see what type of accuracy you can get with these Criterion barrels. When we initially zeroed one of my scopes, it was crazy to see like rounds touching and how easy it was to make that happen. For you guys out there that already shoot precision or long range, this is nothing new to you guys. You guys know all about barrels and rifling, and I've been getting slowly educated and learning more about it as we go. But for guys like me, like I'm talking about, just getting into this type of stuff, this is really cool. Continuing on, the build will come with a mil-spec enhanced bolt carrier group with a nitride QPQ finish and ambi charging handle, a rifle-length gas system, and a 15-inch M-Lock handguard, and also included will be a Surefire Warcomp muzzle device, which is perfect since I run their SOCOM RC2 suppressor. Of course, the upper and lower receivers are made from 7075 aluminum with a Type 3 hard coat anodizing, and you can have it Cerakoted in gray, OD green, FDE like I did, or a midnight bronze. Something to note here, lead times from ADM are around 6 to 8 weeks, and with the current industry crisis with parts, these exact specs may not always be available, so it might be subject to change based on component availability. And also something like this is gonna run you between $1,800 to $2,000 depending on the exact specs you choose, which I think is extremely reasonable for a completely ambidextrous billet gun with all of the high-end components and features. So I definitely think the price is reasonable. Okay, now let's get to what you guys all really came here for, the range footage. I've had this rifle for a little over a month, and in that time, I've actually taken it out to an actual AR Precision match here in Vegas, where I placed 11th out of 30. I'm really stoked and happy about that, because considering I'm new to the AR Precision game, I was happy with my performance. I've also taken the rifle out to do some nighttime shooting with Eric and Matt. This was done using a Digex N450 digital night vision scope, and also my primary arms 2.5-10 with white light, with a mod light to be exact. We'll go into that here in a minute. The footage on this is really cool, and it was fun because we did it with the whole night vision camera stuff. Then lastly, John and I went out to see if we could hit out to 800 yards using my buddy Mushi. We borrowed his primary arms 1-8 Raptor ACSS scope, and I'm happy to say that even with the wind that we have today, we were able to still get out to 800 yards and get that shot. So pretty stoked on that, and we will show you that footage. Impact. All right, so let's break down each range segment and what the purpose behind each of them was. First, let's start with AR Precision Match. These matches are held once a month here in Vegas, and they consist of about 12 to 15 stages where shooters will shoot anywhere from 200 yards all the way out to 650 yards. This was my third match ever and first with this rifle, and I have to say that this was probably the best I've done so far in regards to my actual performance. I was able to get most of my hits, and I didn't have to spend a lot of time getting into position as the rifle was easy to manipulate and maneuver. For these matches, I typically run the 2.5-10 Raptor ACSS from Primary Arms with their American Defense QD mount. I really dig these mounts as they are easy to get on and off and maintain zero still. Since we do a lot of reviews here on the channel, I'm constantly switching out stuff on rifles, so having mounts like this one from ADM makes this really easy for me to do. Now, I've also had this Pulsar digital night vision scope for a few months, and I haven't had any time to get out to the range and shoot with it. With this build and the weather getting really nice, I figured it was a great time to go out and put it through the paces. So Eric, Matt, and I headed out to the desert around like 4 p.m. We set up our targets, got our zero dialed in, and then we hiked up this mountain. I have to tell you guys, these shoots are really fun to do. We get there at like 4 p.m., and then we didn't even leave till like a little after midnight because we were all just having so much fun. So it definitely beats any day in the office, and if you have opportunities or like a place where you can do this in your area, I definitely recommend it. We hiked up to three different spots on the mountain, and we shot from unorthodox positions in each spot. I figured this was the best way to put the ADM SPR in a realistic type scenario, as well as test out the Digex digital night vision scope. When we got to each of the three shooting spots on the mountain, we shot from the spot in two different configurations. The first being with the Digex N450 and a Modlight IR850 weapon light. If you're familiar with our channel, then you know that we have a special camera designated for filming in full color IR. This camera it's been modified so it picks up more ambient light and IR light as well, which lets us see pretty much in the dark. Otherwise, all you guys would see is a small little flash, and all you would hear is a little thump right before
impact.
One really cool thing about the Digex N450 is that it records internally since it's digital. This was great for us as we can match up the footage so you can see not only like the position that we were shooting from, but also what we actually saw through the scope when shooting. The other setup we shot was with the ADM SPR using my primary arms 2.5-10 that I use in matches and a Modlight OKW head. So we just switched out the head to that OKW. And if you're not familiar with Modlight and their like lightsaber-like capabilities of the light itself, we definitely think you'll want to check them out. We shot a little past 275 yards, I believe 278 to be exact, and using the Modlight OKW weapon light, PID was very easy. So something to note here with this range session, I brought Matt with us. Matt is a new shooter. He's only ever fired an AR-15 one other time before this. He's never done any type of shooting that's long range, never like used an LPVO, and with him using this rifle as a new shooter, he was hitting all three targets we had all the way out to 278 yards, 275 yards, and he was doing it consistently. Definitely brought a smile to his face. And now I know some of you out there are gonna be thinking, well, 275, 278 yards, that's not really that far. And yeah, I agree, guys. However, where we live, the furthest shot you'd be taking to defend yourself would not be anywhere near that distance. In addition to that, how many people can say that their first time shooting an AR with an LPVO was from a mountaintop at night at distances of 275 yards plus? I don't think many people can say that, especially saying they did it like in night vision type capabilities. So yeah, definitely for me proves that this is definitely a sweet setup and a sweet rifle. Now, the last grain session I did was with my buddy John. We had a few rounds left over of that 77 grain PMC X-TAC, and I borrowed my buddy's Primary Arms 1-8 Raptor ACSS scope to try it out. I'm looking at purchasing this scope, so definitely a perfect opportunity to put it to the paces before I decide to buy it. I wanted to see if I could hit out to 800 yards with this setup, so John and I went out and zeroed the 1-8 scope, and then we put out a few targets. The first being the mini ADAP target from TA Targets. Guys, this target is literally 8 inches wide and 16 inches tall. It's tiny. And we put it out at 600 yards. As you can see, we were hitting it with no problems whatsoever, even with the wind. When we started shooting out to 800 yards though, the wind really started to play with us. However, I did manage to score one hit before we ran out of this expensive ass ammo. You're talking like, I think almost $1.12 to $1.20 a round right now. I can definitely see another day where we're gonna go out and try to hit 800 yards again or more consistently, or even 1,000 using my 2.5 to 10, that Primary Arms first focal plane scope that I've been using for matches. So I'll say this again, guys, this was crazy to me as I never thought that 223.556 round was like capable of doing these distances. So I'm really like stoked to see that a lot of the guns that I have currently are able to do this, and it gets you pumped and more motivated to go out and do this type of shooting. So guys, that's gonna wrap up our review on the American Defense Manufacturing UIC Mod 2 SPR. Guys, overall, I think that this specific rifle is awesome and will definitely be my go-to for AR precision matches, as well as long-range shooting. With all three range sessions, we ran over 1,000 rounds easily through the gun, and they were all suppressed, and I did not encounter any malfunctions. This is to be expected, as American Defense Manufacturing has always put out quality rifles from my experience with them in the last, I wanna say, 6 years. Before we go though, I did want to note a couple things, especially for you local law enforcement guys here in Vegas. At the last match I was at, there happened to be someone from the LVMPD range staff shooting the match with us. He and I got to talking, and he confirmed that since ADM is already an approved manufacturer for the department, if anyone who was in the SPR program wanted to run the 18 inch UIC Mod 2 SPR for duty, they'd be permitted to do so since the platform has already been approved. That's great news for the guys and gals on my old department, because now they can run this gun since it's already been approved, and there's not going to be any, I mean, obviously you got to do the qualification, but other than that, you're good to go. So I definitely think that if you are part of the SPR program here in Vegas, you're going to definitely want to take a look at this specific model, this offering from American Defense Manufacturing. Guys, thanks everyone for checking out the video. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up down below. That does help us out a lot. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing, because we post new videos every week. And if you want to support our content, check out that Patreon link down below. Patreon members get first access to new content, new gear. They get special discounts, special codes, giveaways, stuff like that. And they're a huge reason why we can keep creating this content for you guys all to check out. So thanks again for watching. And as always, I will see you in the next video.
Jesus, man.
Dude, I think all of this.
You're good. It's my butt.
Oh wow, I'm not wearing my. I was like, I lost all my hearing. All right. I didn't realize.